More than 20,000 are going to lose their jobs. Pontiac salesmen, their Pontiacs, and union workers just breathing a sigh of relief. Here's why. They were barely hurt at all. Their benefits barely touched at all. And those much maligned legacy benefit costs pretty much not touched at all. My next guest says the UAW is botching it all. Here's Mark Brenner. What do you mean?
Well, first off, I think you've got to rewind and let's go back over what they gave up. They took what was already 75 cents on the dollar in terms of the value of their pensions, and now they're going to trade most of that in for company stock. That seems like a bad deal if you've worked 30 years on the assembly line to me.
All right, but the argument for doing a lot of the things they've done, if they didn't do them, the company would be in a lot worse shape. What do you say?
I think that, you know, what we've proven in 30 years in the auto industry since concessions started with Chrysler is that they don't work, that basically they haven't saved the company.
Are there too many? I've heard one story, Mark, that there are too many auto workers, period, for the type of business it is today, for the number of cars they sell today, just way too many workers.
Well, I think that they definitely have dramatically shrunk their workforce even before the
2005. No doubt, but still like a boatload more people than we need.
Well, the big problem that they complain about, you know, is not the active workers, it's the number of retired workers. And they're, you know...
Why don't they ever address those costs?
The retiree costs.
Right. The ones that are the $19 billion bane of GM's existence.
Well, they were floating it out till now, hoping that one day they'd get out from under it. I mean, look, when they were paying billions back in dividends in the 90s, nobody was saying a word. Their stocks were flying high. They, you know, GM put $2.5 billion to buy Fiat, and then 4 years later turns around and pays another $2 billion to get out of that deal. We didn't see a dime of that. And so after all these mistakes, all these rewards to the shareholders and their bondholders for decades, now they're saying, oh, too bad for all these retirees who actually made it possible for
well,
these companies,
you know,
to be profitable.
Well, it's a fair point, but we are where we are, and it is what it is, right? I mean, and the argument could be made, and everyone says, oh, Neil, you sound so callous saying this, but I've seen in all sorts of industries, and to my own dad, you know, that... The pension you thought was guaranteed doesn't materialize. Your company goes out of business, and the government pays you pennies on the dollar. Do they see that coming?
The UAW.
Yeah.
I think they had their heads in the sand a little bit, and even now I think that they're
playing. They have their heads right now in an even darker place. And I just think now they got to look around and say, all right, no one wants to take promises away from folks who worked very hard and thought they had a guaranteed pension. I can understand that. But they've got to go back to those same folks and say, if we go out of business, the pension you covet and treasure and richly deserve is going to be pennies on the dollar, right?
I don't know which is going to be worse, honestly. The deal that they've got with the VEBA taking stock or going to PBGC, I don't think either one
PBGC is the pension benefit guarantee corporation. That pays the pensions for companies
that go out
of business.
That dump them onto the taxpayers.
And they're dumped on it at like a fraction of their value. So... Do workers see that, or do they think they can dodge this bankruptcy bullet?
I think they think that they can dodge it, especially you know, given where the leaders are trying to lead them. But look, if Walter Reuther were alive today, he would be calling for, you know, we're going to own 89% between the union and the government, 89% of General Motors. Why are we actually looking at restoring the company to profitability as our aim here? Why aren't we tackling the environmental crisis the way we tackled World War II right after Pearl Harbor?
So you say if you collectively look at the bigger picture, everyone benefits, and they're
Absolutely.
Not doing that.
I don't see any other way.
I love having you on. You're a great guest. But a lot of the other union honchos avoid me like the plague. At first, I thought it was my deodorant. Then I discovered they just hate me. So why... Are guys like you able to articulately and clearly state a way out of this mess? You're doing it. They're not. Why not?
Well, I think they've basically seen their interests tied to the companies for too long, and they haven't been able
to
actually articulate the vision.
So you think they're in the pocket of the corporate bosses, so they're no different.
Of course they're different. The question is, are they too close? And I think absolutely. Look, Ron Gettelfinger sitting there at the congressional hearings with folks. A friend of mine asked his wife, which one is Ron Gettelfinger? She picked him fourth out of four.
Really?
Absolutely. They've completely lined themselves up with the company. People don't see any distinction. And unfortunately, it hurt the union, because if we were out making our case, as you articulated it, that these are folks who worked 30 years, they earned every penny of their pension and their retiree health benefits. If they were actually leading demonstrations here on Wall Street, you know, talking about why are we honoring AIG contracts and not honoring union contracts, I think there'd be a lot more movement in their direction.
Well, you know, we can disagree on a lot of the finer points, but you present then a fine argument, and I don't see the counterparts at UAW and the top ranks doing it, then that's going to be their undoing.
I agree. Unfortunately, they've walked themselves into a blind alley, and hopefully it's going to be up to the members to get themselves out, because ultimately they get to vote on these contracts, and I hope that they see the light that we're talking about here.
All right. Well, thanks, buddy.
Absolutely. Good to be here.